Till now, we already studied about the electrostatic electric field due to point charges, due to discrete charges, due to continuous charges. In this chapter, we are going to study the scalar quantity of the electric field, and this is called electrostatic potential. The electrostatic potential is represented by capital V. Now, the potential, as the name comes here, the potential is a very familiar term. You already might have heard this term. The potential represents the flow of charges from higher potential to the lower potential when we talked about the electrical circuit. For example, a ball that rolled down the hill. Why this ball is rolling? The ball is rolling because the ball has a tendency to roll from higher elevation towards the lower elevation. Similar is the case for the electric charges also. Now in this chapter, we will study in detail about the electrostatic potential. Now, if I ask you that the body is moving, then it means that the body possesses some amount of energy. If the body don't have any energy, then that means the body is at rest. Here we are considering the flow of charges, the ball moving. So that means we are considering the movement of the object. And if the body is moving, it has some amount of kinetic energy. If we talk about the electrostatic potential, then the energy with the object is called the electrostatic potential energy. So before going further, first let's understand this very important term, that is the electrostatic potential energy. In order to understand the electric potential energy, let me first show you a very simple diagram. In this diagram, you can see that there is a source charge which is represented by plus capital Q, and this is placed in a uniform electric field. If we bring a very small test positive charge near to that of the plus Q charge, then they have the tendency to repel each other because both are positive in nature. So the positive Q charge, that is a source charge, repel the test positive charge, and this repulsion occurs by the electrostatic force, which is also called the electrostatic repulsive force, and it is denoted by F capital E. Now this is a normal tendency of a positive charge. In this condition, if I apply an external force, okay, this external force is represented by FEXT. EXT stands for external. If this external force is applied on the test positive charge, such that the test positive charge overpower the FE, which is the repulsive force, and moves from, let's say, point A towards the point B. Now, this FEXT, which is the external force, is sufficient enough to overpower, or we can say to counter the repulsive external force, and it moves the test positive charge from one point to the another point. In the diagram, the points are A and point B. What happens that when the charge moves from one point to another point, then there must be some work to be done. If the charge moves from point A to point B, then there is some work done. Okay, this work done is stored in the test positive charge in the form of potential energy. So what happened? That we are applying the external force on the test positive charge, and it moves from one point to the another point, and this work done is stored in that particular charge in the form of a potential energy. In the next condition, the charge is placed at point B. Okay, this charge comes at point B by the external force. As soon as the external force is released, then the test positive charge has a tendency to move towards the point A. Why it has a tendency? Because again, the electrostatic repulsive force come into play, and it draws the test positive charge from point B to the point A. So we can say so that the potential energy, which is already stored in the test positive charge, is now converted into the kinetic energy. So this is all about the potential energy. So we talked about the electrostatic energy, which is stored in the charge. charge. Now, from all the points, what we have studied that at every point, the kinetic energy and the potential energy must be constant. So, this is called a law of conservation of energy. According to this law, we can say so that the energy can neither be created, it can neither be destroyed, but can only be transferred from one form to the another form. You can see from this flow chart, demonstrates you what we have studied till far. In the first block, we have seen that the work is done in moving the test positive charge from point A to the point B, and this work done is converted into the potential energy. Next, when the external force is released, then the potential energy gets converted into the kinetic energy. So this is all about the electrostatic energy. Now let's see the formula associated with it. In this formula, you can see that the work done in moving the charge from point A to the point B is represented by WAB is equals to the integration is there from A to B, because we are talking of every point from A to B. And what we are integrating? We are integrating FEXT, which is the external force. And the integration is done with respect to DR, which is your position vector. Similarly, if this formula is calculated for the electrostatic repulsive force, then what happened? Then the formula would be this. You can see in this formula that there is only a difference of negative sign. Why this negative sign is there? Because F external and FE are both in the opposite direction. So FEXT and FE are in opposite direction. So the formula also reveals the same with a negative sign on it. Now, there is another formula for the potential energy. The potential energy at point A is given by capital UA. Similarly, the potential energy at point B is given by capital UB. If you have to find the potential difference, okay, that is the electrostatic potential difference, so it is given by delta U. Delta U means the difference in the potential is equals to UB minus UA. This gives the potential difference between the point B and the point A. Why in this condition UB is created at higher potential? Because when we have started our journey from the point A, so it has the least or the minimum amount of potential energy, because from that point the work has just started. As soon as we reach to the maximum point, that is point B, the work is done. So whole amount of work then is converted into the potential energy. So with respect to point A, the point B has maximum potential energy. That's why it is given as UB minus UA, not UA minus UB. Now, according to these formula, the electric potential difference has a particular definition. Now, let's see the definition. It is the work required to be done by an external force in moving without accelerating a charge from one point to the another for the electric field of any charge configuration. Now, from this definition, you must be clear about all the terms which is given to that. Okay, there is one important term which is mentioned in the definition, that is without acceleration. What do you mean by without acceleration? Now, acceleration is only done when the force applied is maximum. In this condition, the external force that we are applying is not maximum. If it would be high, then the body should move with acceleration. But in this condition, the external force that we are applying is just sufficient to overpower the repulsive electric force. That means F external should be equals to F of E. This is not very high. If external force is not very high, so that means the body does not move with acceleration. So there is an important term, without acceleration. Similarly, I have also mentioned of any charge configuration. Of any charge configuration means the charge can be of any shape, any size. It can be a point charge, it can be spherical charge, it can be a square and so on, various shapes I am talking about. So it can be of any configurations. Now let's talk about the electric potential energy at infinite. When we talk about electric potential energy at infinity, then we talk about that there is a zero amount of energy. That is, U at infinity is equals to zero. Now, if this condition we put in the formula, okay, the formula is that WAB is equals to UB minus of UA. Okay, that is delta U is similar to that of the work done. We have already discussed about it, that the change in the potential difference is equal to the work done, because work is done from A to B is similar to the potential energy. So here we can write that WAB is equals to UB minus UA. Now, if suppose we consider that point A is at infinity, okay, point A, what is point A? Point A is the point from where the test positive charge has started its journey. Okay, if we suppose this point A at infinity, then that means we are considering the charged object from infinity to any point, let's say a point B. So in this condition, A becomes infinite. So you can put it in the formula that UB minus U of infinite. U of infinite already told you that it becomes zero. So what is the formula now? It becomes WAB is equals to UB. So you can say so from the formula that it is the work done in moving the charge from infinity to that point. In this condition, the point is point B without any acceleration. After studying all the key points, there is one important point to remember. The important point is that the work done in moving the charge from any point to any point, like for example from A to B, it is independent of the path chosen. That means you can take any path to move from one point to another point. In the Coulomb's law, we have seen that R is the straight line path, but in this condition, the path can be any path. It can be a zigzag line, it can be a curved line, it can be any line that the work needs to follow to travel from A and reach to point B. That means the electrostatic potential is conservative in nature. So this is a very important point that we need to keep in mind. Now let's start with the very important topic that the name suggests, electrostatic potential. Okay, this is the name of the chapter, but you will say that I am coming into this topic, to the concerned topic, after a very long journey. Yes, that base was very important for you to understand the electrostatic potential. That is, in order to understand the electrostatic potential, you have to first go into the detail of potential energy. Now let's get into the detail of what is this electrostatic potential. The electrostatic potential is basically the study of space. Okay, for space, I mean, like for example, we talked about the electric field. The electric field is also the study of space. At space, we consider the uniform electric field. It comes into role when any charged body is placed in that particular space. Then you realize that what is the property of this electric field. Similar is the condition for electrostatic potential also. This is not about the study of any particular charged object. This is about the study of whole space. Okay. Now, according to the definition, as you have studied, the electrostatic potential energy, which is equals to the work done. So, if we relate the electrostatic potential with that of the work done, so what will be the definition in this condition? Now, let's see the definition. Electrostatic potential is the work done per unit charge from bringing the charge from infinity to that point against the electrostatic force. Now, from this definition, it is clear to you that we are talking about the two point, okay, that is the work to be done in moving the charge from one point to the another point. In this condition, the point A, okay, the potential at point A is called VA, and at point B the potential is called VB, and if we take the difference of it, so it becomes VB minus VA, and the difference is given by delta V. Now the formula becomes work done per unit charge, as we have already studied in the definition. So work from A to B becomes WAB upon the charge, that is Q. The Q is the charge which we bring from point A to the point B. What is the formula for WAB in the condition of potential energy? It is UB minus UA. If we talk about the electric potential, so it becomes upon small q. So this is all the formula which relates the electric potential with that of the work done, and it also relates the work done with that of the potential energy. In the definition, you have seen that we are talking about that the charge comes from infinity to that point. Okay, so now A is considered to be at infinite. If A is at infinite, so the potential energy at point infinite is equals to zero. Now in this condition, the formula modifies to VB minus V of infinite, because VA becomes infinite, is equals to W. Okay, AB, A becomes infinite, so infinite B upon Q. So this is the condition when we talk about the infinite position. As we have already seen that the work done in moving the charge from one point to the another is independent of the path followed. So this is called a conservative nature. Now, there is also a property of a conservative nature that if the work is done in moving the charge in a closed path, then the total work done should be zero. So this is the statement which I narrate to you, but can I prove it? Yes, I can prove it by a very simple diagram. In this diagram, you can see there are two points A and B. Okay, there is one path which is followed from A to B, and there is another path that follows from B to A. So it becomes a closed curve. We have to find that the net work done in A to B from one path to the other path should be zero. So now if we consider the first path, that is from A to B. So in this condition, the formula modifies to WAB upon Q. So what is the potential energy in this condition? The potential energy should be VB minus VA. Why VB minus VA? Because the point B has higher potential as compared to point A. So WAB upon Q is equals to VB minus VA. Similarly, if we talk about next path, that is if we talk about the path from B to A, okay, in the reverse path, so in that condition the formula becomes WBA upon Q is equals to, the potential now becomes VA minus VB. Now these are the two equations. You just add the two equations. If you add the two equations, then you will get WAB upon Q plus WBA upon Q. But if we add the potential, so it becomes VB minus VA plus VA minus VB. All the terms cancel out and you will get zero. So this proves that the work done in moving the charge in a closed path is zero. This is the conservative nature of the electrostatic forces.